the Niners might trade Brandon Aiyuk. ESPN's Dan Graziano wrote today in ESPN Insider that he expects the Niners to trade Brandon Aiyuk, and it's the same logic they used to trade DeForest Buckner. They could keep Aiyuk. They could afford it. But they wouldn't be able to fill other holes, and they might have to lose players like Greenlaw and Juszczyk and Hufanga. But if they trade Aiyuk, they could keep all those guys, improve those weaknesses, and then draft another wide receiver to replace Aiyuk. Isn't that sort of the logic they used to get rid of Buckner? I don't know. What do you think? Do you see this happening?
Do I see it happening? I think it's a possibility with this 49ers organization. Should they? Absolutely not, in my opinion. It seemed like they shouldn't have. It was a mistake training Buckner. Buckner, Aiyuk, they're both the kind of guys you just don't even think about trading. They do everything right in the offseason. They do everything right during the season. They're not scared to do the little things. They're not divas. Aiyuk is the best route runner, the best hands. He's the best receiver on the team. He's a willing blocker, which is hard to find from a wide receiver. He always comes in ready to go, in great shape physically. Trading Brandon Aiyuk seems like a mistake to me. It seems unnecessary also because, right, you could restructure him now, give him an extension, and it doesn't affect you for at least a year or so. It wouldn't affect them this season if they did that. And then they could move from Debo after this season. That's the way I would play it. I'd rather have Brandon Aiyuk long-term. He's younger. He's better. You know, restructure it. And then Debo can be traded, not this year, one more year with Debo. But after that, you can move on from Debo. I think that's the plan I would take. Now, whether the Niners take it or not, I don't know. They shouldn't have traded Buckner, and they did. So it wouldn't surprise me if they end up trading BA. I definitely would not, though.
I think what's funny about this, I think they're going to trade Brandon Aiyuk, and I think it's a mistake. Just like I thought it was a mistake they traded Buckner. But I think you're seeing a lot of people right now saying, it's not going to happen. People who are covering the team, not going to happen, nothing to talk about. If it does happen, the team's going to have to give up a king's ransom to get this guy. If and when it does happen, you're going to hear the same people say, this was brilliant. This was the right move, which is so cynical and intellectually dishonest. It would be the wrong move, but I expect them to do it. Because they don't use him enough. If they wanted to pay Brandon Aiyuk, they'd throw it to him more. They can't really justify spending all this money on wide receivers and running the ball as much as they do. Like, they're 32nd in pass attempts this year. I don't think they ever expected Brandon Aiyuk to get this good. And I think they feel, for the amount of targets they're giving to that position, they shouldn't be spending that much. That they could probably get a guy in a rookie deal and get 80% of Aiyuk's production for, you know, a fraction of the price. That's what I think they're going to do. And I think what's interesting is, you know, you could justify it. Maybe, I mean, if they get the pick right, it could work out. Like, they have a late first round pick. They could trade Aiyuk for a high first round pick, use that on an offensive lineman, and then take a wide receiver later in the first round. If they get both of those picks right, they're geniuses, but they're not the greatest drafters. Well, they had two good draft picks the last 2 years.
Here's the thing. I mean, this is still a win now team, right? They have an opportunity to go after it again this year, right now. And if you get rid of Brandon Aiyuk, who are you going to replace him with? I don't see anyone on the 49ers roster that can replace Brandon Aiyuk. And if they draft a guy to replace Brandon Aiyuk, even Brandon Aiyuk was in the doghouse his first year. Brandon Aiyuk wasn't Brandon Aiyuk his first year. So the odds of them landing another Brandon Aiyuk or someone as good as Brandon Aiyuk in the draft and also playing and reaching the field and having success is like slim to none right now. And if you look at what happened in the Super Bowl, Debo Samuel, 11 targets, 3 receptions. He was awful in this game. So to me, when I'm looking at this roster, I'm bringing back Brandon Aiyuk. I'm keeping Debo one more year. I'm making a run with those guys again. And then after this year, I'm moving on from Debo Samuel. They can't afford, like you said, in this offense to pay two receivers top end money like that. But they can't afford to pay one. And if I'm going to pay one, I'm paying Brandon Aiyuk, not Debo Samuel. Is Grant frozen? There you are.
I feel like, didn't you learn your lesson from the DeForest Buckner, Javon Kinlaw thing? Like, it sounds great on paper. Hey, you know, just trade this guy and replace him in the draft. But what if you get a guy who isn't as nearly as good as Brandon Aiyuk? Because it's like Brandon Aiyuk isn't just a good route runner. He's also a great blocker. He's also really tough. He also knows the offense. He's also like, he's also a team leader. He practices hard. You sure you're going to get all that from the guy that you draft? What if you get a guy who's got a bad knee or isn't nearly as interested in blocking?
Yeah.
I don't know.
They can't afford it. It's a no-brainer to me. Brandon Aiyuk, and I've been saying this for over a year and a half because there are rumors about it. Last draft, there are rumors about them trading Brandon Aiyuk. Brandon Aiyuk is not the kind of guy you traded. He's exactly what you want from a football player, particularly in this offense. He knows this offense. He's one of the best blockers that you can have as at the wide receiver position in the NFL. He's not the kind of guy you trade. I'm telling you, the smart move is, now, I don't know what the Niners are going to do, but the smart move is get him a new contract, keep Debo, one more year with both of those guys. After this year, you find a way to move on from Debo Samuel. That's what I would do.
I would think so, too. I'm gonna go further with this. So let's say the Niners, I just don't see how you keep both Debo and Aiyuk. It's way too much money tied up in wide receivers on a team that doesn't throw. That throws less than any other team in the league. But if you trade Aiyuk, how would Purdy feel about that? That's Purdy's number one target. That's his favorite receiver. He says it.
Yeah.
So he trusts the most. An older quarterback on a second contract who has more leverage and money and power would maybe speak up and say, absolutely not, I need this guy. Maybe not publicly, but privately. But Purdy's 24, Aiyuk's 25. They should be playing together for the next 10 years.
Exactly.
They're, you know, like just like Steve Young and Jerry Rice were about the same age. I think Steve was 1 year older than Jerry Rice. Those two should be playing together. They're linked. Like, 100%. If anyone has to go, it's Kittle or Debo. They're a lot older than Purdy. They're not going to be here that much longer.
Yeah, and I think, like I said, I think the way the contracts are laid out, even if you give Brandon Aiyuk a new contract this year, it's going to make it more affordable this coming season, and then your real problem is the year after that. But to me, that's Debo Samuel at 30 years old, who's not playing like he was a couple years ago. That's when you move on from Debo Samuel. You move on from him at that point. But BA should not be going anywhere. He is a staple on this team. In my opinion, you don't move on from Brandon Aiyuk. But here's the thing. That's my opinion. Would it surprise me if the Niners decided to move on? Not really. Because they've made mistakes like this before. You see what they did with Buckner. And it's the exact same thing. You move on from Buckner, who do you get? No offense to Kinlaw. He's coming along great now. It's been like 5 years for him to get to this point. Who's to say that they replaced Brandon Aiyuk with anybody that's going to be able to take his place anytime soon? It would be a huge mistake. I think if they move on from Brandon Aiyuk, it's the beginning of the end. I don't think they can make it back to the Super Bowl without Brandon Aiyuk.
Yeah, I mean, look, the Vikings traded Stephon Diggs, who's a lot like Aiyuk, and then drafted Justin Jefferson. If the Niners can get the next Justin Jefferson, everyone will be okay with it. But saving that, it'll be tough because Aiyuk, like, you trade him but not Debo. When Aiyuk does everything right, like Aiyuk never misses game. He missed one game in the last 3 years. He practices hard. He plays hard. He runs every route hard. He blocks. Like, that's the guy you trade, not the guy who runs half speed when he doesn't have the ball, or the guy who misses games every year, or the guy who's a little bit heavier than he's supposed to be. That guy stays. Like, what does that say about your culture? You don't reward the guy who does everything right and steadily improves? Why?
Yeah. It would make no sense to me. I hope it doesn't happen because I don't believe, like, who's going to replace him? Ronnie Bell? I like Ronnie Bell, but he's not Brandon Aiyuk.
A rookie.
Who is?
A rookie.
A rookie. And so that's a big if. Mm-hmm. That's a big if. If you hit on him, if he's good, if he understands the offense, if he's willing to be a blocker, you don't know any of those things. You can't take this risk. You got to keep BA around.
On the other hand, though, let's think about, let me try to make an argument for it. If the Niners want to really invest in their offensive line, let's put it this way. The Chiefs would not pay Brandon Aiyuk.
True.
They wouldn't. They wouldn't have paid Debo either. They didn't pay Tyreek Hill. They're spending really nothing on their running backs and wide receivers. They spend on quarterback and offensive line.
Yeah.
If the Niners feel they have a special quarterback, protect him. And they don't have a pick high enough to get a premium offensive lineman. But if they trade Aiyuk, then they would. And that's, to me, the kind of a trade that the Chiefs would do. Trade Aiyuk. Get an offensive lineman with that top 15 pick or something, if you can get that. and then try to replace Aiyuk in end of round one or somewhere in round two. Possible.
Here's the thing. For one, you don't have Patrick Mahomes. Brock Purdy's not Patrick Mahomes. No disrespect to Brock Purdy, but he's not Mahomes. Their offense is a little bit more open. It's a little loose, right? With the 49ers, it's a very structured, rigid offense. Do this. You got to do this specifically. And if you don't do it, you're not playing. You got to block. You got to do all this. It's harder to find a BA that can fit into this offense and do exactly what he's doing than it is with the Chiefs, who you just need a receiver that can run routes and catch. It's a different system.
I'm making an argument for trading Aiyuk, but just for the sake of conversation. Yeah. I think you could argue that it's harder to find great offensive linemen, especially for the Niners, to find great offensive linemen than it is for them to find excellent skill position players. Like, you even put it out the other day. I mean, the Niners have had a really tough time finding good offensive linemen since they've been here with Kyle. Really tough time. Like, the best guy they've drafted is Aaron Banks, who isn't a Pro Bowler yet.
Yeah.
Is he?
I think a majority of the problem that the 49ers have had in landing offensive linemen isn't that they've missed, although they have missed, they haven't prioritized it. They had 11 draft picks last year. Not one went on an offensive lineman. Yeah. They could have got DeJuan Jones, who's going to be a hell of a player for a long time. He was available. They got
the one time they spent the high pick on an offensive lineman, it was the wrong one.
Right. Lynchy. Exactly. Yeah. So they have to prioritize it. In general, you're right. It is harder to find an offensive line than a skill position player, but it's a little different with this system. It's very detailed. It's very specific. You got to do certain things a certain way to make Kyle happy and to get playing time. Brandon Aiyuk has gone through that whole process. He's mastered it, and he's the best receiver on this team. I think the 49ers have enough draft capital to go after linemen. This is a very thick offensive lineman draft class, especially at the tackle position. There are a lot of good players out there. If they prioritize and go after it, I think they can find that guy. They got to retain everybody they have and then find those depth pieces, because that's the thing, is I think we're going to talk about it later, but even if they nail it with the offensive lineman, what's the odds of him playing first year? Even Aaron Banks didn't touch the field the first year.
Well, that's why I'm saying draft. Think about it this way. I'm just getting Brandon Aiyuk out of town right now. Yeah. If they want someone who can start right away at right tackle, right away, and potentially maybe move over to left tackle and replace Trent Williams, who's getting kind of old and didn't play well at all in the Super Bowl, I mean, you're not going to get that guy most likely at the end of round one. You're going to have to get that guy with a top 10 pick or a top 15 pick. And the only way you're going to get that is by trading Aiyuk or the head coach. You could do that. Yeah. I don't think they will, though.
Yeah. No.
Or they could trade the quarterback. What do you think Brock Purdy's worth in a trade right now? Just kidding. But seriously, what's he worth?
Brock Purdy right now? First round draft pick somewhere in there.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't know. Mid first.
Yep. Yeah. I would think so.
They're not doing
that. He's probably worth more in a trade right now than Aiyuk, because you don't have to pay him and he's a quarterback.
Yeah, they're not trading Brock. They're not trading Kyle, that's for sure. And I don't think they trade BA.
Brandon.
I would be surprised if they trade BA. I really would. I don't think that's the move. I think this is – I mean, there's – guys like Troy Fatanu from Washington, he should be available when the 49ers draft 31st in this draft. He's a really good player. I think there's going to be some good offensive linemen available when they draft. I don't think that's the right move. I think they're going to – honestly, I wouldn't be surprised, Grant. As much as we want them to replace the offensive line and upgrade the offensive line, it would not surprise me at all. And matter of fact, I expect it to be the same starting five that finish the season next year. Right.
I mean, so there's something to be said for that. Like, it's not like Colton McKivitz. It's not like any individual offensive lineman was just embarrassed in the Super Bowl. The problem was that schematically, the Niners couldn't get enough blockers on the field to pick up the Chiefs blitzes, and that's schematic.